Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. What a beautiful day to have the celebration of our confirmation and First Communion. It's the feast of the body and blood of Christ as well. And so it's like a special day that every year we remember how special the Eucharist is. And for you children, it gets to be your First Communion day as well. How many people here, the others, the adults, remember your First Communion? It's like one of the most special days in your whole life. You'll never forget it. And for you, it will always be on the Feast of Corpus Christi, or the Feast of the Body and Blood of Jesus. So it'll be like having a birthday and Christmas on the same day. And it's beautiful for you. And I'll tell you another thing that's special. How many are back to church for the first time tonight? Is there anybody back? It's many of you. And so to do that on the Feast of the Body and Blood of Jesus as well. We didn't even get to do this for Easter for everyone. But this year, how special it is. And it's special for you children. We remember those who have yet to be able to come. And even as we pray with them today, and they'll join us in video, I'll tell you, they remember their First Communion. And right now, they thirst for the day when they will be able to go again. And all of that thirst and hunger that is there is all about how important Jesus is to us. And you have been waiting, and even having to wait extra this year. But all of our prayers are going to come together in one celebration where God enwraps you and then fills you. And that's beautiful. Calling to mind how we all could do better at serving the Lord, we ask God's mercy to prepare us. Lord Jesus, you come for those who are sorry for their sins. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you come to forgive us and make us your own. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you plead for us and pray for us at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
We adore you.
Let us pray. O God, who in this wonderful sacrament have left us a memorial of your passion, grant us, we pray, so to revere the sacred mysteries of your body and blood, that we may always experience in ourselves the fruits of your redemption, who live and reign with God the Father in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated for our readings.
A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses said to the people, "Remember how for 40 years now the Lord your God has directed all your journey in the desert, so as to test you by affliction and find out whether or not it was your intention to keep his commandments. He therefore let you be afflicted with hunger and then fed you with manna, a food unknown to you and your fathers, in order to show you that not by bread alone does one live, but by every word that comes forth from the mouth of the Lord. Do not forget the Lord your God, who brought you out of the land of Egypt, that place of slavery, who guided you through the vast and terrible desert with its serpents and scorpions, its parched and waterless ground, who brought forth water for you from the flinty rock and fed you in the desert with manna, a food unknown to our fathers." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. Our reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, the cup of blessing that we bless, is it not a participation in the blood of Christ? The bread that we break, is it not a participation in the body of Christ? Because the loaf of bread is one, we, though many, are one body, for we all partake of the one loaf. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory
be in our minds, be on our lips, and in our hearts this holy day. On the first day of the Feast of Unleavened Bread, when they sacrificed the Passover lamb, Jesus' disciples said to him, "Where do you want us to go to prepare for you to eat the Passover?" He sent two of his disciples and said to them, "Go into the city and a man will meet you, carrying a jar of water. Follow him. Wherever he enters, say to the master of the house, 'The teacher says, where is my guest room where I may eat the Passover with my disciples?' Then he will show you a large upper room, furnished and ready. Make the preparations for us there." The disciples then went off and entered the city and found it, just as he had told them, and they prepared the Passover. While they were eating, he took bread and said the blessing, broke it, and gave it to them. And he said, "Take this, this is my body." And then he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it to them, and they all drank from it. And he said to them, "This is my blood of the covenant, which will be shed for many. Amen, I say to you, I shall not drink again the fruit of the vine until the day when I drink it new in the kingdom of God." Then after singing a hymn, they went out to the Mount of Olives. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
At the beginning of Mass, I asked everyone to remember their First Communion. And I'll tell you, there would be few of us who don't have that memory as a very, 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 very clear memory of a special day. And it was special for lots of reasons. One, our family and friends were able to gather around us. But I remember it as being something else. Somehow I was able to be taught that this was a special day because I was going to be old enough, mature enough, to be able to say to Jesus, "I love you enough to know right from wrong in my life and know that I choose you, Jesus. I choose you to be a part of my life, now and forever and ever." And I remember my confirmation too as being that kind of day, a day that I remember it meant that I was one step closer to adulthood, that I was making this choice for myself. So first of all, parents and godparents, grandparents, family, thank you all for getting these youth to this point. And the whole point that they are here for and sitting here is because they are old enough to choose Jesus, and they have chose Jesus, and we have helped them. and we will need to help them more along the way. But there's something very special about sacraments, isn't it? I like to tell people sacraments are about God's love, and so maybe we can understand them most in the way we love. So, children, you remember telling your parents that you love them, right? The day when you say that to them, or each time you say that to them, it doesn't mean you just started loving them right then. Or parents, remember when you met your wife or your husband, and the first time you said, "I love you," and they were able to say, "I love you back." Did it mean you just started loving them at that moment? No, we grew in love. But when we say the words, and when that covenant is returned to us, something new happens each and every time. Each and every time we grow in love. It is not as if God has not been with you up to this point, children. He always has, and he always will be. But you're entering a special covenant with him with these sacraments, where you are able to say, "I choose Jesus. I choose to follow God and to be people of virtue, and to pray that those gifts of the Holy Spirit don't just come upon you, but everybody will be able to see them in your life by the way you try to live." And if only we all would remember our first communion every time we receive Jesus, so that we would really know that Jesus is with us. And we live that way, as if Jesus was right with me all the time, present in my reflection. That when I look in the mirror, I would somehow see a little bit of Jesus, but know that he was there, all of it, in me. Do you know what, youth? That's the prayer I have for you today. When you receive the Holy Spirit, and then you receive Jesus in the Eucharist for the first time of many, that you actually are able to say that confession of faith today and choose to be a child of God for the rest of your life, and that you'll do your best to reflect Jesus and how you live in the people around you, and your sponsors who were chosen for you are people that have strived to do that too. Will we do it perfectly? No. But I promise you this, you have the tools to get back up and try again. We all do. And by doing that each and every time, it's like saying to Jesus, "I love you" again. And we grow in love with the Lord. And he grows in his love for us and how we are able to reflect God's love to the world. This is a special day for you, but it's special for all of us. And each and every time we receive our Lord, his true body and blood, Jesus is with us, as true as he is in the tabernacle, where we say that's the holy place in this church because that's where Jesus is kept. And he's kept somewhere else too. He's kept in the people that sit in these pews, those that will join us today from far away. And today, you will join that communion. Jesus will be kept in you from this day forward. And it is a beautiful day about becoming more adult. And the Lord Jesus will help you with the gifts of the Holy Spirit, and confirmation will be exactly what they're meant to be. Strength and guidance and God doing God's part to bless you. With that, I'm going to invite our confirmation students and First Communion students to come up to the stairs where I told you, and with your sponsors to come up as well.
This is a big book. And it's a big book because it has
a lot of prayers in it. And among these prayers, you know what? I have the wrong big book. This is the one with the Word of God. I need the one with the prayers for confirmation. I flipped to that golden ribbon thinking, I found that ribbon. And I did, but in this book. One of the first things that we always do in sacraments is to remember how much we love our Lord Jesus. And we always proclaim our faith. And so you get to proclaim your faith today too. I'm going to get to the prayer that we do all the time, but in the form of remembering our baptismal promises. At your baptism, your godparents were able to do this for you, but today you're old enough to do it for yourself. And that's part of the reason why you waited till this morning. Here we go. I'm turning back to the Easter baptismal promises, because those are our baptismal promises where we all remember them, we all repeat them. Can you all stand with them, please? Dear brothers and sisters, through the Paschal mystery, we have been buried with Christ in baptism, so that we may walk with him in newness of life. And so now, together, we remember our baptismal promises. And we all renew them together with these children who are about to receive these two beautiful sacraments. And so I ask you all, do you renounce Satan? I do. And all his works, I do. And all his empty show, I do. Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth? I do. Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is now seated at the right hand of the Father? I do. Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of our sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting in heaven? I do. This is our faith. We are proud to profess it through Christ our Lord. Amen. And now I ask you to confirmand me, to bow your heads, and I'm going to pray a prayer over you. Lord our God, through the gift of your sacrament of confirmation, pour out your Holy Spirit on these confirmandi. Help them to know the gifts and the fruit of the Holy Spirit, born in their lives, begun at baptism, but now in a special way, fanned into flame, so that you may always know them as your disciples and know that they will serve you and love you their whole life. Send the Holy Spirit upon them to breathe on them the gifts of your love. Thank you. sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Cody, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. We bring our prayers before the Lord.
For the church, that through our sharing in the Eucharist, we may be transformed more and more into the body of Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For governmental leaders, that God will give them wisdom to address the unrest, insight into righting the injustices, and words that will unite society. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who cannot receive the Eucharist at this time, that God will strengthen them and make God's presence known to them through their spiritual communion. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
All in holy orders, that their lives will manifest God's love to all, and their service help people experience communion with God and others. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For deeper communion with Christ, that as we receive the body and blood of Christ, we may take on the mind and heart of Christ and continue the mission of Jesus. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are confirmed today, that they rejoice in the gift of the Holy Spirit, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who receive the Eucharist for the first time today, that their hunger and thirst for Christ continues to grow every day, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty and ever-living God, the sacraments are your gift to us. May we always remember your gift of the Eucharist is there to feed us, to nurture and guide us. And may your gift of the Paraclete, the Holy Spirit, give us the tools to help us to be your witnesses in the world and to anoint and protect us on our journey. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated as we prepare the altar. brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Grant your church, O Lord, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace, whose signs are to be seen in mystery in the offerings we present here. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For at the Last Supper with his apostles, establishing for ages to come the saving memorial of the cross, he offered himself to you as the unblemished Lamb, the acceptable gift of perfect praise. Nourishing your faithful by the sacred mystery, you make them holy so that the human race, bound by one world, may be enlightened by one faith and united by one bond of charity. And so we approach the table of this wondrous sacrament, so that bathed in the sweetness of your grace, we may pass over to heavenly realities here foreshadowed. Therefore, all creatures of heaven and earth sing a new song in adoration, and we, with all the hosts of angels, cry out with joy. So that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." history of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and all of our patron saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased, confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth. With your servant Francis, our Pope, Stephen, our bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own, listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, to our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. For there we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Savior Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. The body and blood of Christ.
Is my way received, and what a
Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood remains in me, and I in him, says the Lord. Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, we pray, that we might delight for all eternity in that share in your divine life, which is foreshadowed in this present age by our reception of your precious body and blood, and who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God come down upon you and remain with you forever. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
This Mass is ended, we go forth praising God with our lives.